Hi, this is Irma from Food for Healthy Bones, and I'm here with Skelly, the skeleton that lives in us all. And my idea is to bring spice into your life. Now, let me start with a little bit of a story. I never really liked spices. I thought, I don't know, they're a little too, sharp or tough to handle, tough on my belly. But as I've gotten older and traveled the world and saw the value of spices from a I don't know, from a exotic point of view, I decided to start tasting them. And today we're going to make tandoori spice. Now, of course, you can buy this, but I want to tell you how many ingredients and show you how many ingredients go into tandoori spice. But before I do that, I want to bring you into my memory. When I traveled to India, Thailand, Bali, and even Costa Rica, I would see the spices, especially in India. The markets that were full of mounds and mounds of these magnificent spices. In Thailand, the same thing. I thought to myself, this is gold. And actually, it is, because spices, as we know, according to the Silk Route, this was a key commodity that people were going after from the point of view of just bringing up more flavor into your food. Now, tandoori spice has ginger, cumin, coriander, turmeric, sea salt, paprika, it could either be smoked paprika or paprika, and cayenne pepper. Now these two are from the pepper family, which is a nightshade. So if you have problems with nightshades, this is not going to be a spice combination for you. But basically, it's a teaspoon of each of these, not the cayenne. Cayenne is only a pinch. A teaspoon of all of these that we're going to combine together. Because we have so many delicious ingredients in the tandoori seasoning, I'm going to read some of the health benefits. Ginger, as we know, is mind-boggling as far as what it can bring to the body. Now, this is the spice versus the whole ginger, but just let me touch on a couple of things. It helps relieve nausea. It fights fungal infection. It protects against stomach ulcers. It eases menstrual pains. May inhibit cancer growth. It regulates blood sugar. It relieves joint and muscle pain, lowers cholesterol levels, improves bone health, blocks bacterial infections, eases inflammation, and promotes proper digestion. Now, this is from draxe.com, but this has all been studied, and he quotes the 14 studies that he makes reference to. So that's ginger. Ginger in the whole form, or you can grate it and have ginger tea. Wonderful thing to do. Here's the benefits of turmeric, T-U-R-M-E-R-I-C. It supports cognitive function. It supports a healthy inflammatory response. It supports the cardiovascular system. Promotes youthful, radiant skin, promotes healthy mood balance, and supports joint muscles and health. There are many, many, many more incredible ingredients about turmeric. Paprika is, as I said, it's a member of the capsicum family, so this is a nightshade. But the health benefits are antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, relieves pain, stimulates the production of saliva and stomach acids, which improves digestion. And the minerals and vitamins are A, C, E, and iron. Cumin. Cumin in your bones. Eat more soy protein, or taking soy supplements is commonly suggested as a way to prevent, delay, or even reverse osteoporosis. That's because soy is a phytoestrogen. Now, I'm not talking about taking soy supplements. I'm just talking about cumin and how cumin is a phytoestrogen and is good for your bones. Researchers are looking at cumin as a possible bone protector because it's rich in phytoestrogens. And the health benefits, cumin has been found to effectively stimulate immune function in a way that may benefit immune-compromised individuals, also known as the seeds of good digestion. The vitamins and minerals are B1, iron, small amounts of manganese, copper, calcium, magnesium, and phosphorus. Coriander, which is one of the other ingredients, is the dried seed of the cilantro plant. It's one of the world's oldest seeds and spices, and seeds were found in the Tutankhamun's tomb. So this goes way, way back as far as coriander. Health benefits are soothing irritable bowel syndrome, easing chronic constipation, decreases bad LDL, increases good HDL. And the minerals are C, K, small amounts of calcium, phosphorus, and potassium. The smoked paprika, as I said earlier, oops, I already said about the smoked paprika, and that is it. The sea salt, we know that that has tremendous benefits. So I hope that you try it. And again, you don't have to make your own. You can buy it as long as it's organic. And let me know what you think. Tandoori seasoning is a great new spice combination to give it a try. As I said, you can buy it already pre-made, make sure it's organic. And you could sprinkle this tandoori seasoning in eggs, chicken. I'm going to show you how to make tandoori cashew nuts, which are yummy, a great snack. And also in chickpeas, and I'm going to show you that afterwards as well. So please follow my recipes because this is all leading to a bigger possibility of all these ingredients coming together. So that's it. Thank you for joining us. Food for Healthy Bones. Oh, Skelly just mentioned to me, quietly mentioned, if you'd like to have more recipes like this, or if you'd like to become part of my community, go to my website, foodforhealthybones.com. And in the, when you first get there, you'll see my 5 bone loving recipes. Sign up for that and you'll be part of my newsletter, which I mail out monthly, and you'll get to know all about Food for Healthy Bones. That's it. Bye for now.